Hello, Namaste, Sat Sri Akal, welcome to our channel Aarti World. And from this video onwards, we'll be taking up a series of projects which are done by architect Sanjay Puri, who is one of the most leading architects in India. We'll be focusing upon his design concepts and the design thinking process. The first project that we've taken up is The Street, which is a 800 student accommodation in Uttar Pradesh. So without any further delay, let's jump into the video.
The site is located in Mathura, Uttar Pradesh, and the climate is humid subtropical with dry winter type, with parts of western UP as semi-arid type. The street designed by Mumbai, India-based Sanjay Puri Architects is a 800-unit student housing complex on the campus of GLA University in Mathura. And the designers took advantage of a wedge-shaped site between repetitive blocks to create a complex of radially aligned four-story tall structures informed by more organic organization and expression of traditional Indian cities. Founded in 1992 by architect Sanjay Puri, the firm Sanjay Puri Architects is one of the most sought-after architectural design firms in India, and with a team of over 72 employees that work under skillful guidance of architect Puri, the firm is an unmatched powerhouse of designing, and it has extensive design portfolios that includes architectural and interior design projects in fields like hospitality, commercial, retail, educational and entertainment facilities, as well as large urban projects which also include town planning. Talking about the architectural features, the orientation of all the buildings are done with a view of generating large north-facing garden areas overlooking a vast playground towards the north. In addition, each hostel room is punctuated with a wedge-shaped bay window oriented towards the north and the playground. Each hostel room has ventilation openings in the interior corridor facilitating cross-ventilation. All these factors create an energy-efficient building, minimizing the heat gain in response to the climate. These north-facing bay windows reduces the heat gain and also provides privacy to the students. Two focal areas are created at the ends of the linear buildings to house cafeterias, game rooms, and gymnasium, opening into the north-facing gardens and terraces. Each of the public buildings are large volumes with 20 feet high ceilings, and the organic layout of the buildings characterizes each space within the site, and the color accentuates different blocks and facilities within. Each block is differently colored, with the internal face of the bay windows of the hostel in bright colors to create an identity. Rainwater harvesting and water recycling and usage of solar panel additionally make the project more energy efficient, along with the orientation and facilitation of natural ventilation. The project is contextual to the site and the orientation of the site, thus creating varied experiences and changing perceptions of space in each part of the site. Each student room has a distinctive angular bay window that faces north to capture daylight and heat in the winter months and limit heat gain for the remaining 8 months of the year when the average temperature is above 30 degrees Celsius. Louvers in each window provide sunshading while permitting natural ventilation. And the overall air circulation is further encouraged by openings at regular intervals in each block where the form shifts in plan. Also, these irregular parts of the floor plan are filled with breakout spaces that provide natural light into the double-loaded corridors. Canted roof lines reprise the bay windows at a more public scale and marking these indoor gathering spaces while also sheltering monumental outdoor stairs from the elements. Talking about the concept, the layout evokes the organic nature of the old Indian cities, with garden spaces increasing and decreasing in width. The hostel circulation spines are being angled along their length. Taking a cue from the old cities of Mathura Linear low-rise hostels were twisted up gradually across the site, creating an organic layout of built form and landscaped spaces. This creates individual spaces within a dissembled identity in each part of the layout. Coming on to the site plan shows us the various hostel wings and various common areas such as cafeteria and game rooms, along with how the landscaping is done in such a way that each hostel room can have a view of the landscape. Then talking about the spaces that are there in the hostel complex are the dormitory entry, the cafeteria, games room, the common toilets, staff apartments, different hostel wings, gardens in between, and gym. So in this slide, we have zoned out the various common areas and the washroom areas and different activity areas and the staff dormitory on the site plan. This gives us a clear study of how the places are arranged and zoned out on the site, with washrooms which are placed at a very equal distance from one another so that there is easy access to all of them. And the common areas such as the activity areas and the cafes are centrally placed in such a way that all of them can access them. So next we have zoned out the different spaces as public space, private space and the semi-public spaces. As we can see, the public spaces are spread out on the entrance of the site just in front, such as the cafe. Then the private spaces includes the students' dormitory and the activity areas. And in the semi-public, we have staff dormitory and washrooms. Then we have the ground floor plan, which again shows us the various cafeteria and games rooms and the various hostel wings that are there. Then we come on to the typical floor plan, which is very similar to the ground floor plan only. So this slide talks about the circulation pattern of the staff. So they have been given a separate entry from the back where they can access their staff dormitory and also the staircase which leads to the common activity area rooms and also the cafeteria areas. Then we have the student circulation, which shows us that students have the maximum circulation throughout the site. They'll be going over to the cafeterias and different hostel wings and the activity areas as well. So here we show some of the area blow-ups of the different areas such as the staff dormitory, the game rooms and the gym, and also a blow-up of the hostel wing, one hostel wing, which is repetitive and similar in all the wings. Then we come on to the elevation and section. So we have amazing elevational details such as those bay windows, which are the main highlight of this project. And the schematic section shows us a section through a hostel wing, which shows us the corridor and the rooms on the both sides of the building. Then we got this 3D view of the whole project, which clearly shows us and helps us to visualize how the spaces are managed and planned. Then we have these photo gallery of all the interior spaces, the main spaces. The first one shows us a typical room, single room in which a student is sitting. Then we have the dining area. We can also see the ceiling highlights what type of block it is. So the interior and the exteriors complement each other. Then we have this activity area or the gym. So to quickly sum up, the occupancy of this hostel was 800 students. Then we have the area. The climate was humid, subtropical with dry winter. And talking about the concept was to have a complex of radially aligned four-story tall structures which are informed by the more organic organization and expression of traditional Indian cities. Then talking about the planning, Separate building units are being utilized for community spaces as well as private living spaces, and this does not require any artificial cooling, and we have separate hostel wings for girls and boys. Talking about the material, basic white tiles, hardwood flooring was used, and in the rooms were natural stone finished, and pastel colored ceilings were there with whitewashed walls. The floor had patterned stone which blends with the Grecian landscape. And these are some references.
Thank you so much for watching the video till the end. If you find it beneficial, then do like, share and subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you get notified every time we post a new video, and stay tuned to our channel because we'll be getting a lot of brilliant projects by famous architects. And you can also post your suggestions in the comment box. And bye bye.